Hello, my dear students. Let us take the third case, that is the strain energy stored in a body when the load is applied with impact. Okay. So here what happens, sometimes in the factories and workshops, the impact load is applied on a body. For example, when we lower a body with the help of a crane and the chain breaks while the load is being lowered, the load falls through a distance before it touches the platform. Okay, when we lower the body with the help of the crane, the chain breaks, means it is breaks while the load is being lowered. The load falls through a distance before it touches the platform. See here, you can see this is the rod, and when apply the load here, this is the load and this is the bottom platform. So this the load is, because of the chain breaks, the load is while the load is being lowered, the load falls through a distance before it touches the platform, so it gives the impact on the platform. Okay, so for such case, how you calculate the strain energy? Let us see that. Now let us consider a bar subjected to load. This is the bar and applied with the impact as shown in the figure. Now let P is the load applied with the impact, then cross sectional area of the bar, that is A, and E is modulus of elasticity of the bar material, and L is the length of the bar, and delta L is deformation of the bar, and the stress is sigma is stress induced by the application of this load with the impact. Then H is height through which the load will fall before impacting on the collar of the bar. Okay, so in this case what happens, the formula is saying work done is equal to load into distance. Okay, here in this case the load is given by P into H, okay, plus delta L, that is the deformation. So that is the change here. You have to consider this is P into H plus delta L. Okay, so here the strain energy stored, that is same formula, U is equal to sigma square divided by 2E into A into L. Then strain energy stored is equal to the work done. Therefore, this equation sigma square 2E divided by 2E into AL, that is equal to now P into H plus delta L. Simplify this here, you get this is the formula. This simplify, after simplification you get stress is equal to P divided by A plus or minus square root of P divided by whole square plus 4 into this L divided by 2 into P E H divided by A L. So again, if you simplify this, you get this formula, that is P sigma is equal to P divided by A into 1 plus or minus square root of 1 plus 2 A E H divided by P L. This is the formula to find the stress in the case of the impact loading. Once the stress is obtained, the corresponding instantaneous deformation or the strain energy stored may be found out as usual, means usual strain energy formula, that is U is equal to sigma square 2EI sigma square divided by 2E into A into L or volume. But sometimes what happened that the loading this is very small, I mean deformation is when delta is very small as compared to H. Okay, when the deformation is very small when compared to the height, then it is work done is given by P into H. Okay, that time the deformation is neglected. See the same formula, P into H plus delta L. This is the case when the height is not so much and deformation is also there. Such a time you have to use P into H plus delta L. But sometimes what happened, the deformation delta is very small as compared to the height H. So in such a case, work done is equal to P H, and when you simplify this, you get stress is equal to 2 EP into H divided by A into L. So these two formulas you have to remember while solving the examples, because here when delta is small, you have to use this formula. When that is deformation is there, then that effect has to be considered. In that time, the stress can be calculated using these two, this formula. Okay, so just see the difference. When the deformation is considerable, that time this is the formula to find stress. When the deformation is very small, then it has to be neglected. So stress is given by this formula. Okay, let us solve one or two, three examples on this. A 2 meter long alloy bar of 1500 mm² cross sectional area hangs vertically and has a collar securely fixed at its lower end. Find the stress induced in the bar when a weight of 2 kN falls from a height of 100 mm on the collar. Okay, so here E is given, that is 120 GPa. Also find the strain energy stored in the bar. So here it is given what, 2 meter long, the length of the bar is 2 meter or 2 into 10 raised to 3 millimeter, and cross sectional area is 1500 mm², and weight of falling on collar of the bar P is equal to, that is 2 kilonewton, 2 into 10 raised to 3 newton, and height of 100 mm. Okay, so the height is here very much, I mean it is 100 mm height, and modulus of elasticity is given 120 GPa. Okay, so that is 120 into 10 raised to 3. See here, we know that in this case what happened, you have to calculate first stress, because to find the strain energy, it requires to calculate the stress. So in this case, extension of the bar will be small and negligible as compared to the height. Okay, here the deformation is less. Okay, because but height is more, it is falling from a height of 100 mm. So from the extension of the bar will be small and negligible as compared to the height from where the weight falls on the collar due to the small value of the weight. You can see here the weight is only 2 kilonewton, but the large value of the height, that is H, is equal to 100 mm. So the stress induced in the bar is can be calculated by using this formula. Okay, because here the deformation is neglected, so that is the second case. Sigma is equal to square root of 2 EPG divided PH divided by A into L. So what is this? Everything is given here. 2 into E is Young's modulus, 120 into 10 raised to 3 into P. P is the load, 2 into 10 raised to 3 into H. H is equal to 100 mm divided by A into L. Area is given here, that is 1500 into L. L is 2 into 10 raised to 3. So you get stress is equal to 126.5 mega Pascal or 126.5 Newton per millimeter square. So once the stress is calculated, you can find what is the strain energy stored in the body. So what is the strain energy that is given by this formula? U is equal to sigma square divided by 2E into V. So sigma, it is calculated value, 126.5 whole square divided by 2 into E is 120 into 10 raised to 3 into volume. Volume is given by this, calculated by V is equal to L into area. L is 2 into 10 raised to 3. Area is 1500. So you get 3 into 10 raised to 6. Substitute here. So you get energy stored in the bar is equal to 200 into 10 raised to 3 Newton millimeter or 200 Newton meter. Very simple. Only you have to take care of while calculating the stress. Here the load is very small, but but the height of the fall is high more. So in that case, you have to use this formula to calculate the stress. Once if you get the stress easily, you can calculate what is the strain energy stored in the bar. Okay, let us take one more example. A steel bar 3 meter long and 2500 mm² in area hangs vertically, which is securely fixed on a collar at its lower end. If a weight of 15 kN falls on the collar from a height of 10 mm, determine the stress developed in the bar. What will be the strain energy stored in the bar? Take E as 200 GPa. Okay, here in this case, the length is given, 3 × 10⁻³. Area of the bar is given, 2500 mm², and weight falling on the collar bar is 15 kN here, and height is 10 mm. So modulus of elasticity is 200 GPa. So here you can see that the load is more, and even the height of the fall is less here. So in this case, extension of the bar will be considerable because there will be the deformation as compared to the height from where the weight falls on the collar. Due to the large value of the weight, that is 15 kN, and small value of the height, 10 mm. In the previous problem, the weight was less and the height was more. So that's why extension deformation was not considered. So used stress formula, the simple one. But in this case, what happened? The weight is more and the fall, height of the fall is small distance. So we have to consider the extension deformation. So the stress is, in this case, the stress is calculated by using this formula. Stress is equal to P divided by A into 1 plus square root of 1 plus 2ae into h divided by p into l. Okay, substitute all the terms what you have. P is given, that is 15 × 10⁻³ divided by area. Area also given, 2500 into 1 plus square root of 1 plus 2 into A is 2500 and E is 200 × 10⁻³ and H is 10 divided by P is 15 × 10⁻³ into L is 3 × 10⁻³. So simplify this, you get 95.4 into Newton per millimeter square, or 95.4 MPa. This is the strain induced in the bar. Now you have to calculate what is the strain energy stored in the body. So strain energy is given by this equation, sigma square divided by 2E into volume. So how you can calculate volume? Volume is equal to length into area. Length is 3 × 10⁻³ into area is 2500. So simplify this, you get 7.5 × 10⁶. Okay, so once if you get this volume, substitute in this equation, sigma square divided by 2e into volume. So simplify this, you get strain energy stored is equal to 170.6 × 10�³ Newton millimeter, or 170.6 Newton meter. So this is the second case. You have to consider the effect of deformation or extension. So for that, you can use this stress formula. Once if you get the stress, you can easily calculate what is the strain energy induced. Okay, let us take one more example. You just read this, you can calculate this. Okay, so here also it is asked to calculate the a copper bar of 12 mm diameter gets stretched by 1 mm under a steady load of 4 kN. What stress would be produced in the bar by a weight 500 N? Stress you have to calculate. The weight falls through 80 mm before striking the collar rigidly fixed to the lower end of the bar. The Young's modulus of the bar material as 100 GPa. Okay, so here the load, two loads are given. One is P1, that is 4 × 10⁻³, and P2 is 500. it. So first you have to calculate the area that is pi divided by 4 into d square. Then you find the deformation. Okay, because you have deformation is equal to PL divided by AE. Here deformation is given, that is 1 mm. So but we don't know L. So L can be calculated using this formula. So that is L, you will, if you substitute in this equation, you get L is equal to 2.83 into 10 raised to 3 millimeter. Once if you get L, you can calculate what is stress. This is the load also more and the height of the fall is less. So you have to consider the stress, to calculate the stress, you have to consider this formula. So substitute all these things, you get stress is equal to 162.52. Thank you.